Okay, guys, I wanted to welcome you back to 7 Days to Die. I figured out how we're gonna upgrade our base. So basically, this next level, we're gonna put all of our stuff down here, but it's gonna end up like a bunker, and it's not gonna be 11 by 11 because I'm actually gonna come in one more with the wall. That way we have a double thick wall, and on the outside is concrete. But until we can get concrete, which requires us to get an engine, I'm not going to finish the actual wall part of it. I'm just going to finish, underneath these spikes and underneath the actual wall itself. That way when we go to upgrade, so you'll see what I'm talking about here, when we go to upgrade, we'll be able to hit all of this shit all at once, and then we won't have to worry about that block right there being cobblestone. It'll be concrete too. I mean, I don't know if that really matters, but I'm not sure if we can get it from the outside or not. That's my only concern. So basically, this is what I'm going to be doing tonight, and then in the morning, since I fucking rebroke my leg again, we're going to be running around our little town that we have, seeing if we can't break up some cars and get a engine. Because I really need to get a concrete mixer going, man. Like, that's the only thing holding me back right now is the engine. I'm pretty sure I have everything else that I need. And, yeah, there's the spikes. So, anyway, this is basically what I'm going to be doing, man. All night. Oops, I think I went one too far. Yeah, that's why I'm making dirt. Oh, shit, I don't know. Is that done yet? No, of course not. Crap. I'm gonna have to make some up just in my inventory. Alright, man. Anyway, I will see you guys in a little bit. Okay, so this is what the size of our base is gonna be. I'm pretty stoked about it. We're gonna have to have a pillar in the middle. And from where the ladder's at, we might actually end up moving the ladder. I'm not 100% sure. Yeah, we'll figure that out later. But anyway, what I did want to show you was I want to go down to stone with this. And I think we have to go, now we'll just dig it up here. We got 1, 2, 3 more to go, I think, until we're at stone. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that that's how far we have to go. So, I mean, that's going to be kind of a pain in the ass, but it's going to make it super strong. So if we have to go another 3 down, that means we technically, after we get this all upgraded to concrete, this roof right here, we can make it whatever block we wanted. And then the same thing with all these around the sides, we can make them whatever block we want. So I'm pretty pumped about it. I think it's gonna look good when we get done. But I'm done digging for right now. And this is just so I don't fall and break my fucking leg. So we are gonna get going. I'm gonna get prepped and ready to go for a little loot run. And if we don't find an engine in this town, then I guess we're going to find another one. And I know where the hub city's at, so I guess you guys can probably put 2 and 2 together and figure out what we're doing after that. So anyway, we're gonna go ahead and cancel these off, and I will see you guys once I'm ready. Okay, guys, we're finally ready to go. I put that other forge down that we got, and I've got it busy cooking up stone and clay because I'm not 100% sure what we're gonna need for cement, but we've got sand for days right here, and if I need to go get more clay, I will. I think I've still got like a bunch of stacks. I made another crossbow, and we're busy making up some cobblestone frames, and I brought some building materials along with us in case we don't find what we're looking for over here. If that's the case, then that means we have to go to the hub city. So I'm probably going to time lapse running around this town for cars. We're also going to be hunting as many animals as we can. And I see a white one right over there. But basically, man, I want to blast through as many of them as I can, because I think this whole thing is full of them under here too. So I'm really hoping that we'll be able to get an engine out of this. I don't see why we wouldn't. Oh, damn it. She went around the corner. I don't see why we wouldn't with as many cars as we have here, considering we got like a purple battery out of like a half broken one. So let me go ahead and time lapse these cars, and let's see if we can't get one. We'll be right back. How about that shit? There's an engine. And look at that, dude. That Shamway was full of mechanical parts. But there's an engine right there, fellas. That's fucking awesome. I'm gonna keep going through all these cars anyway, because I can make another wrench. So I just thought I'd interrupt and tell you, hey man, we got an engine. I need to go on a hunt, and then we'll build that concrete mixer. And then at night we can go ahead. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Piggy for days. Mine, mine, mine. Cha-cha. And I have with me, yes I do, the hunting knife for just such an occasion. But yeah, man, I gotta start leveling up my tools and stuff, because like, I was just so used to using them at the workbench and having them all mixed together, you know? Well, the problem with that is, say if I die, which hopefully I won't, but if I do, that means I can only have whatever tool level I can make, you know what I mean? So it's kind of like, it feels sketchy to just only combine everything, but it's like a good band-aid until you can get the resources to level it up properly. But every time you make up one of those steel tools, man, it bumps your level insanely. So I think that's what we're just gonna keep doing. Let's see if we can peg this deer too. But yeah, I'm gonna get back to the time-lapse or whatever. I just wanted to let you know that yes, we did get an engine, and we will be making a concrete mixer in this video, so I'm pretty pumped about that. Sarah's treasure map. If you found this note, this may be your lucky day. I've been bitten by one of the creatures and the fever has taken hold. I don't have long, but at least I could do before I turn is help someone, as anyone as God would want me to do. If there is still a God, so I leave you this map with one of my buried treasures. Awesome. To a new life. Well, I mean, we cleared out that random horde. That was interesting. I think it was a random horde. I don't think it was a heat map horde. I think it was just one of the roaming hordes. But, I mean, that was pretty fun, right? I mean, there's a good little chunk of them coming at me. That was probably, like, pretty close to the amount of zombies I had for the 7-day horde. You know what I mean? Like, it was pretty good. I don't know. Like I said, I don't know if that was a heat map one or what. But, well, you know what, fuck it, let's just go make the concrete mixer together. That sounds like more fun than taking apart those cars running through that hotel. Cause, oh man, day six, I wasted so much time in that fucking hotel. I couldn't believe how much time passed in that hotel, it was nuts. Like, it was like, oh, okay, everything's going great, and then next thing I know, the whole fucking day is just gone. And I'm like, well, what did I do? I looted the hotel, which is basically the same as looting the apartments. The only nice thing about it was that I got a bunch of leather out of the couches and a bunch of wrenches out of the sinks and stuff, but I didn't need the wrenches and I didn't technically need the leather at that point either. What I needed was like gun books. I needed a pistol book, that way I could have had a pistol for the horde. But I had the crossbow. Crossbow did me fine, didn't screw me over. I was all right, you know, so I'm not too worried. But anyway, what I'm saying, man, is when we go out the next level, we'll come out to basically where the spikes stop, and we'll go another wall at this height, plus all this is going to be dug out, and then we'll have two more layers of spikes, and then the death spikes, with iron bars in the middle again, so I've got, you know, 1, 2, 3 chances to try and get them stopped before they're even in my base, let alone if they start blowing up, they shouldn't be able to blow up all of my spikes and a 2-thick wall underneath. So I don't know, maybe I'm making like an endgame base. I know it's not exciting, it's a fucking box with spikes around it, you know? Like, there's nothing really too exciting about it. But, fuck, if it works, I mean, I want to see the highest day I ever got to, and again, this is me playing on 2-hour days. This isn't like just busting in and trying to see how far I can go. You know, this was just me playing for fun, and I don't remember what alpha it was. But I think I got to like day 60 something, you know, and the hordes were fucking nuts. And the thing was, I was actually living in the hub city at the time, and I was having fun doing it, but basically one of those, oh, they're kind of like the Coronado buildings, but they're all busted out, and you know, they're all crap. Basically what I had done was take like the bottom floor, make it into a farm and all that, and you know, I had like 3 levels to fight them on and hay bales to jump off if shit went completely sideways. But, okay, so what all do we need for the cement mixer? Now, are these still going and burning? Okay, that used up all my fuel, but it doesn't look like it burnt a lot of stuff. So see, that's kind of upsetting. So your forges don't really run if you're not here. At least that's how it appears to me. I don't know, maybe they did. Because I've got 1,500 in there, but I would think that for having it on for 30 minutes while I was literally just right over here, it would have burnt most of that. I mean, maybe not, I don't know. you know, maybe I shouldn't bitch, but I don't know what the load cell is or whatever on the forge yet. But yeah, I just put this one in here to make clay, or to make concrete. Mixer. What are you going to take? Okay, so we have the engine. We just need 25 iron. Okay, well, I got that. I got that for days. So how about we see the mixer again, buddy? Craft. 2 minutes later. Awesome. So that means now we need concrete mixing, which we can buy. Tough fucking dog, man. That's so awesome. Now, so that means I can make cement in here. Yes, I can. Yes, I can. Now, I don't know how much it goes for, one per whatever. I have no fucking clue. But it only takes stone. Ooh. So I don't even need to put clay in you. I could just pop a shitload of stone in you. So if I take the stone out of here, because I've got, what, 1,000 stone in there. So if I take the stone out of you, 250, that's it? Okay, whatever, I'll take it. And we'll do that. And then I'm going to take the clay back out of this too. Well, you know what, I'll leave it in there. 1,500 is not a big deal. But that way we can build the stone, or the cement. Jesus Christ. Okay guys, we got our cement mixer. Sorry, I was waiting for, I busted out those fences, or the fences, the chests that were full of shit, and so in the meantime I went around and dug around, and this is what the depth that we're gonna be at. So basically our ceiling's gonna come down one more. That'll leave us 1, 2, and 3, and then we're gonna have to actually dig into this one for the floor, or maybe we just leave stone as the floor. I don't know. I'm okay with it as long as, like, right under here is still stone. You know what I'm saying? Like, under the wall is still stone. But basically, we are just about ready. And look at this. I got a little sneaky ninja way in here. Uh-huh. There we go. And then here's what our mine looks like. I'm not sure if I showed you guys this. I was going to make this our living area, but I kind of changed my mind when I started going all over the place, you know, trying to dig this shit out, and it's all fucking lead down here. Like, that's how I got so much lead. Like, I didn't find my iron. So I don't know if I gotta go deeper, because see that right there, it looks like it should be an ore. That's lead. Right? This is lead. Like, I have like over 2,000 lead, and I don't have any guns, so it seems kind of stupid to me to keep mining over here. I don't know. Maybe I just need to go deeper for iron, but we're definitely going to get our stones and stuff from here, because it automatically gives you iron and stuff. when you hit these. It doesn't give you a lot, but it gives you enough that you can do something with it. And as far as sand goes, now see this, this is where it's gonna, we're gonna do some testing, and I got the hay bales down. I don't know, that one ladder was upgrading because I was trying to do the thing and I had forged iron on me and I was like, fuck! Yeah, well, screw it, whatever. So, where's my lead? Yeah, see, I got a shitload of lead, man. And I'm pretty sure I already have a bunch of lead. Sorry, the dogs are going fucking nuts upstairs. I'm pretty sure I've already got a bunch. Yeah, I got a pretty good amount of lead in there anyway. So, oh wait, what am I doing? I need into this one. Yeah, there we go. So I'm just pumping stone in here. Let's see, cement. Make another 186, and that's just because the stone hasn't burned. Okay, so now, what does it take? What does it take? One, two stone, and one crushed sand. Ooh, and it takes a lot of stone. Okay, so I got that. Let's try taking half of that and see what happens. Does that mix up everything? Cement. No, that gets me 100 short. Why? Because I need more stone. But 200. So is that 20 blocks? Are they 10 for 10 now? Oh, I got 420 in there. I can't mess with that. So we probably need like 200, right? Oh, I hope I picked that up. And that's going to take a long ass time. And 101. Okay, so that's going to make up all the concrete that I can right now. Now, is there any way that I can make... Let's see, sand makes crushed sand. I'm not too worried about sand. I can make asphalt, cool. Fertilizer. Oh, they lowered this recipe. Awesome. So we're really gonna get a fucking awesome-ass farm going now. Like rocks, only bigger. Okay, so that's cool. We could use that to fill in. Now, can I not make small stones anymore? See, I thought that there was, like, a way that you could make the small stones. Stone. Yes, right here. Small stone. What is that, a workbench? I think that's a workbench, or is that the forge? No, that's the forge. Used in many recipes. Okay. So, maybe that's just what you can pull back out. Need five, have... Yeah, so the stone that you put in, that's the only recipe, is to pull small stones back out. Okay. So, we need to go get some more sand. I want to show you guys how fucking absolutely simple it is to get sand. Our leg is finally healed. Hooray, hooray, huzzah, huzzah. We're just gonna come... I don't know, over here a little ways. Oh, there's a trash can right there. I'll take that. Some lead fishing weights. Now, too bad they have not implemented fishing yet, man, because I would already have myself a little dock. It's a rainy day. I'd have a little roof over my head, and I'd be sitting there just... Sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide rolling. Anyway, so let's see how much we get for sand. We get 10 per hit. So we can... What? Why? Why is this so janky? There we go. So basically, we could just stand over here and hold down the clicky button, and I could take a sip of coffee. And we could get lots of sand. Now, I'm not sure how I got a bunch of sand before. I think it was from destroyed stone. I think. I'm not sure. Uh-oh, ouch, don't hurt me. Okay, good. I mean, this seems like a good way to get sand. I don't know, maybe over in the wasteland is probably a little bit better for it, just because you might get other stuff for it. You might actually get stone for doing this. I mean, we're at 300, and it was... one sand per. So if we had... See, that's what I don't know. I really want to get my upper wall and where all the spikes are to concrete. If we don't get the lower walls to concrete right away, but they're just cobblestone, but then like the stuff that we can't see, like the corners and the top and like the bottom under the floor, you know what I'm saying? If all of that's to concrete, I would be happy with that. So, I don't know. I'm assuming it's probably 10 per. So, man, that's a lot. Ooh. Okay, sand has, like, no structural integrity.
When you build your house, do not build it upon the sand. Build it upon the foundation of the Lord, and then the Lord you shall be happy, and of the Lord that will be happy, and that will make the Lord happy.
Dude, I don't know. I haven't been to church in so damn long. It's just kind of like, why bother? I see the people there, and I guarantee you most of them don't even understand what it means to be a good person to their fellow man, let alone what it means to be Christian or anything else like that. You know what I'm saying? They just watch out for falling driftwood. They just, I don't know, man. They don't. I don't think they get it. Maybe that's me being judgmental. It probably is. I'm not sure. But it just, the whole thing just doesn't do it for me. I don't know. Maybe I'm a heathen. You know what I'm saying? But look at that. Okay, that took what? A little bit of rambling, couple sips of coffee, and we got a full stack of sand. And that's also bueno, because I need some sand for some glass jars. Because our thirst and shit's getting really low. As far as, hello, bird's nest. Where we're gonna put our farm, I was actually thinking, since we got our tree farm over there, that's not really the flattest spot, but if we went over there or across the lake, because eventually I'd like to build either a tunnel or a bridge, and then what I was telling you about tunnel-wise, I have no problem digging tunnels in the stone. I think that's fun as shit, you know, and if we came out, I was already trying to kind of make an entrance. This is just that clay patch, and it's a big old fucker. So, I mean, if we dug all this out, whoa, we'd have a lot of room, right? Well, I don't know, man. I'm just trying to think ahead, but I think that'd make a really cool entrance into, like, a cave system or whatever, you know, like my own cave system. And the main reason, and I know you probably think it's kind of dumb, but the main reason I didn't build up here was a simple fact is, look at the elevation that we're at right now. We're at, like, negative 26. This is at, like, plus, like, 24 or something like that. So basically, if I had forges going and they got smart and just started digging straight at me, they could have dug through all that dirt and I'd have been screwed. At least in my mind, that's how they would have done it. Now, I don't know if they would have actually started digging or if they'd have crawled the hill, but that roaming horde on my Alpha 14 or 15 experimental play on Nav's game, it was 15, basically they started digging through the mountain because they couldn't get over it. So to me, that made me think that, like, okay, well then they're probably gonna come straight in on me, you know what I'm saying? So, okay, oh, we can actually make sand with this. That's pretty cool. So we need stone, we have enough sand, and I wanted to see here, which one of you isn't, you're not doing anything right now. The iron's pretty much almost done. So let's go ahead and take some of these, and I want to see how much it takes to actually make a jar. A glass jar. Glass. You can't use sand for glass? Smelt it in the forge to make glass. Okay. So I need 10. Oh, I see. That's just their generic placeholder item. Well, you know what? Let's just go ahead. Oh, I can't do that. Ta-da. There we go. Let's go ahead and pop that bad boy in there and see what happens. And how many jars and stuff that'll make. Because like I said, if we need more sand, man, I'll just run back over there, go get more sand. And eventually I want to move all my stuff down, but I don't see the point in moving anything down right now when this is a cluster F right now. So I need stone. I need stone. But let's see. Let's see, okay. I want to see how far this shit actually goes. Hammer time? Hammer time. See how this shit works. So if I come up to... Oh, I forgot I took that out. Alright, so if I come up over here... 10. And that's concrete. And that's reinforced concrete. Okay. Hmm. So it's going to be 20 per block. 20 to get to reinforced concrete. Okay, so we got 20 per block, which means we are 11 by 11 right now. So that's 11 and 11, which is 22, and then 10 and 10, which is 42. So you got 42 times 20. That's zeros. Yeah, because it's all zeros. So then 2, no, that's a 4, and then that makes 8. So it's going to take 840 cement just to do the top ring around there. This is going to be a lot of grinding. So Okay, cool. Alright, I got it. It's gonna take 840. Got it. And that's just to do that outer ring. And then the outer ring, come on, should make us nice and defended. Why do I keep falling? And then the cobblestones will do fine until we can get everything else. But if we've got, so then we got the 840, and then we've got another, what, 20, 40, 60, 80, and then another 100, 400 on the pillar. So I need 2,500 cement mix, basically, is what we're going to call it, to just get the bare minimum shit done that I want to get done, and then the rest we'll do. Whoa. Fuck! God damn it, how did that happen? Like, I'm on the fucking hay bale. What the fuck? Did I break it completely? Yes, I did. Son of a bitch! Oh, motherfucker. Like, how does that happen? How do I... Oh, my God. Okay, let me get my legs splinted up again. Did I at least bring home the cloth? Yes. Okay, good. We are going to make some splints, because I seem to just keep breaking the fuck out of my leg. And I'm not 100% sure how that happens. Like, I'm almost curious to watch the video back at that point and be like, okay, how did I not hit the fucking thing? You know what I mean? Oh, shit. Anyway, alright, I will see you guys later. We are just going to grind out, try and get as much done as we can. But I've got the cement mixer now, which I think is awesome. It needs stone before it can be fed, and it needs the... Oh, we made a new wrench. Let's go ahead and put that bad boy together. So see, that wrench is already at a higher level than my good one, right? So I'm already making better tools. So I'm at like 337 on my tools now. Which is not bad. I mean, I don't know what else to make. I mean, I don't know how much these actually level you up. They're actually pretty cheap to make, too. The knife. Because, see, it's 8, right? And then the barb club is like 16. And they take way less time. So let's just queue up 5 of those for the fucking giggles. Everything's off. No, maybe... Yeah, maybe my forges actually did just run out of time, so maybe they are running. That's why I kind of wanted to test it while I was standing around here, just to see, you know, how much it actually does it. I don't know. Oh, shit, come on. With the lag, dude. There we go. I'm trying to get out of here so these guys don't have to sit and watch me dick around forever. So let's make a jar. How many can we make after we put in 230? So... 23, so it takes 10 per... Okay, that's not bad. It's really not bad. Now, how much... Alright, so we're at 240. Is that going to go in? I just want to see... 245, so you get 5 per. So 2 sand is 1 jar. That's not bad. It's really not bad, fellas. Like, that's going to do us good. Let's see, we need the cement mix. We got to keep that a-pumping. So yeah, man, this is what my next couple days gonna be. I don't know if I'm gonna get... I don't know if I'm gonna get all this down to concrete like I want to, but I'm sure as fuck gonna try. And I really hope you guys enjoyed this one. And if you did, you know, make sure you let me know. Leave a like, comment, whatever, if you feel like it. It's totally up to you. Leave a comment. No, I'm definitely gonna get back to you. May not be right away because I do have a day job. So... Basically, all I'm going to be doing the rest of this episode is digging my little heart out and seeing if I can't, I'm just going to leave the splints in the mining chest because that seems like a safer place for them than up here. And that's always where I seem to need them. I don't die to crawlers, I don't die to zombies, I die to breaking my own fucking legs. Look at that, green knife. Nice. Anyway, guys, I will see you guys in the next one, and I really do hope you have a good one, and take care. Bye.